We start off this exciting series to learn programming with the first task, shapes. This is how to learn Scratch programming language. The Scratch program language is free, fun, and easy to learn. Most program languages are text-based, so a learner has to gain experience writing the code. But Scratch program is easier as it uses blocks. The learner selects blocks, puts them together and runs the program in a simple way, making it the most fun and easiest way to learn programming. We're now going to go through each stage. If you want to read the instructions, then please pause the video. Make sure you subscribe, then you'll know when the videos are released. The first command asks us to choose a backdrop. So we go to the bottom right hand corner, you can see choose a backdrop, and we want to go to the library. Here we have a selection of backgrounds that we can choose. And in this task we want the XY grid. You can see there's three down the bottom. We choose the one that we want, and you can see now it's in the sprite area with our cat. Move the cat. Now if we move our cat, you can see that the coordinates are positive in this corner, and if you look here you can see this go to. If we move it onto the area and make it bigger, you can see it says 123.91. I can move that back. Now if we move the cat down, we can see Y has gone to a -75. If we move it to the bottom left corner, we can see it's X is minus and Y is minus. And then the top left, as you probably gather, X is minus and Y is positive. Go to 100, 100. Now we can add a block. Go to block, you can see here, made it slightly bigger using the plus. And now we're going to type in 100 for X and 100 for Y. And if we just move the cat, you can see when we click this block, the cat moves to the coordinates 100, 100. Let's duplicate. Now if we click on the block with the mouse, with the right click the mouse, you can see this menu comes up and we've got duplicate, add comment, delete block. If we duplicate, as you might gather, now there's two. You can see now that the blocks try to join together. So we can join blocks by clicking them together, and we can duplicate using right click. Now how do you think we can make the cat go in a square? Now a square. Now we've got the blocks and a cat goes in a square, but it didn't seem to move because it's too fast, so we need a way of delaying it. Timing. You can see on the left hand side we have these colors, so we can choose colors for different blocks. We're going to go to the control block, and at the top is wait 1 second, and we're going to just change that to 0.2 seconds so we can put that inside the blocks to create a delay. Remember, we can duplicate, and we can duplicate more than one block at a time. So we can use wait, and now when we click on the blocks you can see the cat goes in a square. Events. You might have noticed where the cat goes in a square. Above we have a green flag and a red dot. Now if we go back to our side, our left panel, we can see events. And rather than clicking on a block, we can use when green flag clicked. So when we run a program, we can use the green flag to run the program, and we stop it clicking the red dot. So now when we run our program, we can click the green flag and it will go around in a square. You would also see we can make this stage bigger, so we can have the full screen control, and now we can click the green flag, and now we can see the cat go around in our square. Pin. Something that might be different from the screen for what you've got is this pen item. Now, if you haven't got pen, you can click on the extensions, add extensions. Click once and you'll see these extensions. So music we'll use for xylophone later, but at the moment we need pen. So click on pen and then you'll get these green blocks. So you can see these blocks are the instructions for pen. So now we want to use the pen down block and we want to set the size. So the size we set it to start off with is 10. Now we want to do that before we move in a square. So we add the blocks and we can click on the green flag and you can see we've drawn our square with a pen. Color. We want to change the color, so we can use the set pen color to. So we put that after the erase all. Now we want to change this color, so we can click on it and you can see we've got these options of the different colors. So you can see we can move it up here to red. We've also got an eyedropper, and we click on this, we can move around and click on a certain color on the screen. So let's for now just leave this at this red. Now when we click the green flag, we have our red square. To finish, finally we move our cat back to the middle and we change the backdrop to stars. So we need to scroll down, we can see stars here. So now we have a cat, a red square in the stars. We click the green flag. You can see it does make this square, but there's this line that's not very nice. You can see when we run it again that it does it another time. So if you want to get rid of this red line, how do you think we need to do that? Well, there's a pen up option. So we can start by saying pen up, and we can use the pen down once we've got to the place where we're going to start. So now when we click the green flag, we just have our square. Let's have a look again. That's our red square. So let's make the blocks smaller, and then we can see all of our blocks here. So this is our final code, if you like, our final program for creating the red square. And that's task one. We can save the program just using file and save to your computer, and then we can save the file and it will save as an SB3 file. That's task one finished. But there are other things you can do as well. So let's have a look at the other things that we can do. Something different. How do we draw a square by changing the angle? Well, we can move the cat with this block move steps, and here we've changed it to 200 steps. So we can change, we click on this and the cat moves 200 steps. Now we can change the angle of the cat with turn and degrees. So here we've got turn 90 degrees. We're going to add our delay. Now the pen options we looked at before, quite similar. Now when the cat moves and changes 90 degrees, that's one angle. So we need four angles. So we can use a repeat block, you can see in the control. So we put those move and turn blocks inside the repeat and now add to our pen blocks. Now at the beginning we're going to start in this corner, which is a minus X number and a positive Y number. We're also going to point in direction to the right, so that's 90 degrees. You can see it gives our options here. There's also another option to set the rotation style. So the cat will move and turn in direction. If you don't want it to rotate, then you can use a don't rotate option. If you want to go side to side, there's left right option as well. So we put those blocks together, and now when we run that, you'll see the cat draws the square as before, but now we've used the angle. Now if we change the angle, here we've got turn to minus 120 degrees. So if we try for run that, we can see it draws a triangle. So that's using turn minus 120 degrees. Now if we change the angle again to quite a small angle, when we run it, you can see the cat goes round in a circle. Now it's not a perfect circle, so how do you think we might do that? Use the red dot to select stop. Well, here we've got some code that only moves 3 steps and turns 2 degrees. Now when we run this, you'll see the cat goes quite slowly, but it does go round in a better circle. Let's make that bigger. You can see the cat going round in a perfect circle. Now we're not going to go through all of the code of this example, but when we click the green flag, you can see the cat is making these squares. So we have 5 squares inside each other. So just briefly, we use this variable with a size, and the size increases as we move around in the square. So that's a bit more advanced, but the idea is that you can play around with the blocks and choose what you want to draw. So have some fun and see what you come up with. Well, we hope you enjoyed that. Now, if you're interested in learning more or learning other programming languages, then please subscribe. And every time a video comes out, if you hit that notification bell, then that will let you know.